Hi, my name is Emily Churkin, and I'm the Screen Time Consultant. One question I get all the time from parents is, how do I deal with the meltdowns that come when my kid has to give up a phone, an iPad, a computer, stop gaming? Something that's really important to understand is that we're not having a fair fight with our kids when we ask them to give up their devices. This is because persuasive design, which is the combination of psychology and technology to change our behavior, has been embedded into the products themselves. I've spoken about this before, and you can see more of my videos and blog content on this very topic. We have to remember that it's not a fair fight. These products are designed to hold our kids' attention. And when we take them away, we're interrupting this flow of feel-good hormones to our children's brains. They don't want to give them up because literally the hormones in their bodies are saying, this feels good, I don't want to stop. So they have a meltdown. This is one of the biggest stressors for families, whether it's the two-year-old and the iPad or the tween and the smartphone or the gamer not wanting to stop gaming. So what do we do? Well, first of all, we have to teach our kids about persuasive design. We've got to talk to them about how their brains are being manipulated by the very products they're using. Secondly, as families and parents, we have to recognize that limit setting is really important, and it is our job as parents to set limits. Parents ask me all the time, well, how much is too much screen time? And I give a very unhelpful answer, which is that a little bit of screen time is okay, but a lot is too much. What does that mean? Well, it's really different. It depends on the kid. It depends on their age. It depends on your family's values. It depends on how much time they're spending on screens for school, which during a pandemic might be a lot more than usual. When we can be really clear about what our expectations are for screen use in our family, then we can start to build those expectations around how we actually use the screens. So for example, if we have a family rule that there are no devices at the dinner table, but mom or dad or big brother is constantly breaking that rule, it's gonna be a lot harder to get younger kids on board with that rule when they don't see it being modeled or followed by older siblings or other family members. One of the hardest things about setting limits when it comes to screen time is being consistent. And I would rather, and I recommend this, you pick one or two things that are your quote unquote non-negotiables. That's what I like to call them. What are the things where you feel like you're not willing to bend, that this is the hard, fast rule? Decide that together as a family and make that the one that you work on. This is what I do with my private coaching clients all the time. We pick the non-negotiables and we focus on those one or two things that we really think if we can just stick to for 2 weeks, we will see some changes. But of course, again, the consistency is hard. The other challenge, of course, is that there is this feeling that if I give my kid a phone now, in the short term, I'm buying myself some time, some peace and quiet, compliance. This is true. In the short term, you do buy that. But when that time is up, you get the meltdown. So we have to build in time for the meltdown. And this means we need to acknowledge that our kids are going to have a hard time. We need to tell our kids that we know they're going to have a hard time. And we need to build in the time for them to have that meltdown. So it can be for very young children, you can say things like, I know this is really hard for you. Your brain really likes this and it really wants you to keep playing, but our time is up. And this is the agreement we made. So I'm going to give you a countdown. Here's the timer, whatever it is. And then it goes off. And then you can go and jump up and down, or you can run around the block, or you can, you know, do somersaults, something to burn off that extra energy that your body is going to have and it wants to get rid of. We can give our kids opportunities to do that. And it also helps us to understand and our kids to understand that it's not some character flaw or weakness on their part that they won't give up the screen. For older kids, we need to talk to them before and we need to teach them about why it's so hard for their brains to stop scrolling and why it's so hard for them to get off the game. Because it does help, I believe, when kids understand what's going on for them to make different choices or to at least recognize the fight that they're up against, because it isn't a fair fight. So those are some ideas about how you can enforce, set, try some limit setting when it comes to screen time and recognize that kids are going to have meltdowns and we have to build in time for it. You can check out more of my content on my YouTube channel or on my website. Thanks so much.